Hello, I'm Bradley and welcome to my channel. Today's clip is going to be about something very, very different but affects my life hugely and you wouldn't necessarily know I have the problem. It's overactive bladder, and believe you me, it is something which really, really changes you as a person and really, really affects your whole mood and day to day, and pretty much affects every aspect of your life. Now, I have done a clip on this before, and this is all about an update because, well, and I say update, it's got me thinking this about revisiting this on my channel because I have had several comments in regards to asking me how I've been getting on with this problem since they have watched my first clip, which I will make sure towards the end of this clip that it is attached on there. So if you want to view that, then please do. But this is all about an update on how I've been getting on with the problem I have of a very severe overactive bladder. Now, you may wonder why a 26-year-old man, and I've had this since I was 24. Now, you may think, why on earth have I ended up with this problem? So let's start right at the beginning, very, very quickly, and just to touch on it briefly. First things first, there's a few noises going on in the background. So if you can hear that, I do apologise. I'm just going to carry on and continue through that. So how did my problem start off with an overactive bladder, a very severe overactive bladder, life-changing issue? To be quite frank with you. So my problems came along at the same time as I started having some problems with hernias in my groin. In my lower groin, I have had two hernias repaired there, and I am now experiencing a really painful issue, which is getting quite a lot worse quite quickly, with a third hernia. Now, you might think that's really strange to have three hernias. It certainly is, and again, that really affects you on a day-to-day basis if you've got something as uncomfortable as that which keeps getting at you. Something which became very much of an apparent issue was when I started having problems with the first hernia. That was when kind of it all started to happen with me having a really, really extreme overactive bladder. So for example, with the pressure, my first one was a femoral hernia, which was incredibly painful, an incredibly large hernia, and in the end I wore a truss belt, which is a belt which is designed to keep the hernia up out of the way. Yes, it sounds pretty grim, and it really, really was, and very uncomfortable. I still continue to work very much up to it, got to the point where I could barely walk around anymore with it. It really became to be a really horrific issue. And as things were getting worse, the pressure in that area would kind of just start to be giving me an effect like I would start to need to keep going to the bathroom more. Sort of bladder related, I would need to keep visiting the bathroom. And I thought, to be honest, nothing about it because I was putting up with this pressure in my groin. And I thought that this was pretty normal for if you had a hernia there. The hernia was gradually getting bigger. Now, I do have, about my hernia, I call it a nightmare because it was an absolute nightmare, and I'm still in that nightmare, to be quite honest with you. And that's on my channel as well. So please have a look at that as well. There's lots of things I cover with that, and it's something which means so much to me because at one point I thought all this was over, but it's sadly not. But anyway, getting back to what I was saying, and when I started experiencing that, it would just be a case, first of all, that I would need to keep going to the bathroom, and I thought no more of it. As the hernia got bigger, and this was about midway through 2017, it got to the point where I could barely walk around, actually. Matter of fact, it was really affecting my leg, it was affecting how I was walking, it was giving me problems with my hip, my back. Afterwards, after my first hernia repair, I had to have a lot of physiotherapy to get me back walking straight. Because even my walk was severely adapted by the problem I had there. And of course, the bladder problem became much, much more of an issue after I had the surgery done. I think it was after a couple of days I had the hernia repair done. But an interesting fact is, whenever I've had a hernia there, I have had this bladder water sort of issue going on. So lots of pressure, that pressure not going once you've been to the bathroom to relieve yourself, that's not disappeared. That's still been there. So for example, there would be some days when it first happened to me, I would go in the bathroom, 10 minutes later in the bathroom, 10 minutes later in the bathroom again. And it really affect affected and still does affect my life hugely, to the point really giving me an issue, not just there, but actually psychologically, mentally. I was really, really struggling, really struggling. And in fact, it's strange because we're starting to revisit this as well, because I do have that problem severely. This is an update, but to be quite honest with you, it's just in a slightly different context because things haven't improved for me. And I'm going to keep following this on with how we're going through the events of how we're chatting through it. So after I had that first surgery, a couple of days later, the issue got a lot worse. The bladder-related issues got a lot worse. So weakness, visiting the bathroom often, you name it, I had it. And it was horrific. But it was put down to I possibly picked up an infection. A couple of days after my my first surgery, I was violently vomiting. And you can imagine having a some sort of abdomen scar or from a surgery there. Being sick was not what you wanted to do. So it was thought that I had torn something and it was giving me lots of issues and possibly even nerve-related. So that happened. Now, the problem, I had that for a good couple of months, well into my recovery. I was very, very slow to recover. It was noted by the surgeon that I was very slow to recover from that. And the bladder-related problems, to be honest, got worse. After several appointments with a urologist or a specialist in bladder, I tried a medication, and some days it would help, some days it wouldn't, but it got much worse before it got better. Tried a whole host of different things, dietary changes, so watching things, this is going to sound crazy, but things like tomatoes, which can make almost like the bladder wall angry, can really agitate the bladder wall. So fizzy drinks, for example, changing to decaffeinated coffee, cutting out sugars, cutting out additives, which of course I have a very healthy diet anyway. I struggle to keep a healthy weight because I lose weight very, very quickly. So again, changing already what I had as a healthy lifestyle and actually really changing this again and drawing all of those things back and really being quite difficult on myself. In fact, most of the thing most of what I drank was actually only water. But to be honest with you, it made very, very little difference at all. And I followed this for a very long time. So gradually then I introduced things back in, but, I've always kept the decaffeinated coffee because that's one thing which does make it a little bit worse. So I, as a rule now, I only have decaffeinated coffee. If I go anywhere, I always make a point of asking. And I can tell when somebody's made a mistake and they give me caffeinated coffee, it makes things just that bit worse, which I could really do without. So let's fast forward. So I had that problem for a couple of months, then it gradually calmed down and disappeared in the background. I only had the odd bad day. The morning I had my operation done, I said to the surgeon, it's really, really strange, but I can feel the second lump. Now, after a couple of months of me getting back on my feet, and I think I must have returned back to work in the early February of 2018. This is rough now because, of course, so much has gone on, it's been difficult for me to follow. Straight away, I was fine for about 2 months. Then I had issues again. I felt this lump, the second lump, the second hernia, slightly different place this time, but on my same side. This time it was an inguinal hernia, had lots of appointments, lots of scans, couldn't believe my luck, deeply unhappy, so much going on. And as soon as that started to become a problem, I noticed a dropping sensation. When that became more of an apparent issue, my bladder problem started coming back. It went from having that horrific time to then fathoming off to any a couple of bad days, to then bang, straight back in it. I had this real horrific time all the time, going to bathrooms if I was at meetings, because I was in, I worked in retail banking at the time, so lots of meetings and things like that. Sat down with customers and things in like an office environment. Terrible. All I could think of was, and I mean, back then I was what, 24, 25? Yeah, 24, 25. And all I could think of was, I need the bathroom. Oh my God. And I used to get so incredibly anxious, stressed about it. It was what my whole life went about. I couldn't go anywhere without knowing where a bathroom was. I had to go several times before I left the house, several times on the way to where I was going, several times to wherever I was. Yeah, horrific, absolutely horrific. And then I eventually had the surgery done in shortly after my 25th birthday on the July of 2018. I had that done. Yeah, painful this time rather than just the mesh being repaired on the first time. So in November 17, I had the hernia repaired on the with a mesh cone. In July 18, I had the herniated part removed. The first surgery, rather, as well, I had two lymph nodes taken away, which were infected, which apparently were causing me more problems. The first operation was painful. The second one was more painful. But I think where I had the herniated part taken away, that was where the pain was coming from. And I had more mesh put there. After that, I was again very, very slow to recover, and I had the horrific bladder problem. As soon as I woke up from the anaesthetic, horrific bladder problem straight off, absolutely horrific. And that happened for quite a long time, and again, I was very slow to recover. Lots of physiotherapy because it affected my walking again, which was really awful. And I would say that took me a good 2 months, if not 3 months, to recover. By about the September, I returned to work, I believe. January of 19, I started to have a lot of gastric problems. So I suffer with reflux really quite bad. I've tried lots of different medications for that, and that doesn't never help. But January, I started noticing a dropping sensation. I remember the first time I felt it after having two hernias. I was coming down the stairs at our family home, and I felt a real strong clunk, and I thought, I broke something. Surely not in my age, I can't just come down the stairs and broke something. And it was like I had a golf ball wedged in my groin. And that happened several times. It would fathom off and it would go away, but it always made me worry. So for much of 2019, I was back and forth. Specialists had the endoscopy, the tube down my throat, because I was having so severe problems with my throat. Had a lot of health scares. You can well imagine, can't you? So went through hell with that. Bladder problem, putting up with all this bladder, huge, horrible bladder problem all the time. And do you know what? By the end of, I had so many problems, had a scan, and they said that there was a small amount of something there, but it wasn't enough. They couldn't be sure that there was another hernia, and they didn't want to put me through any more surgery. So I said, that's fine. So I had two courses of steroid injections. The second lot, I could stand up a lot straighter. I could move my leg a lot easier. So, of course, physiotherapy was continuing as well as that. And then that was about midway through 2019. And then as we got to about October, November, December, my groin started playing up again, and I could feel this problem, this horrible problem, which, again, was so similar to having the first and second hernia and those awful experiences. But my bladder problem started coming on severely, March 2019, severely, absolutely horrifically. And it has not stopped since March 2019, whereas before I used to have good days and bad days. And when I had the sort of, it was really bad, then I went in for the surgery, it was horrific. But after I'd sort of recovered, it would calm down a little bit. And I would only get every now and again bad days. I don't mean every now and again, week to week. I'd have two bad days out of a good week. So from March 2019 to now, and we are June 2020, my bladder problem has not given me a break. It's been horrific. I get slightly lighter days and slightly more positive days and easier to bear with it, but I haven't had a day without a bladder problem for, what's that, nearly 15 months. Yeah, it's rubbish. And in December of 2019, I was told I had a third hernia. So from being in the middle of the year, being it was a small part of something which they weren't sure if it was another hernia, or they didn't want to put me through that. They thought it was scar tissue, for example, but I knew it was more, because it was causing me problems. I wasn't able to sort of run, I wasn't able to jump, move about so quick. It was kind of aging me, to be honest. It was kind of aging me, because it was affecting my walking as well. But I have routines and things to try and keep my walking as straight as possible. Now by December, I knew something was wrong, because at work I was having lots of problems, lots of pressure, lots of uncomfortableness, lots of pain. So eventually they sent me for another scan, and I remember seeing the doctor first of all, and I remember them, I was really upset. My mood has been severely affected by this whole experience, and I remember them looking at my scar, and they said that there was a space there and that there was something they could certainly hear and feel. So when I went for the scan, I was told I had another femoral hernia, third one. And we are now June, and I mean, I was trying to change lifestyle because I didn't want to go straight in and have anything done, and so I never pursued anything any further. And up until about January, February, I would say February, March, it hasn't been too much of an issue. It's been uncomfortable, it's been painful, but from March to now, it's really sort of accelerated. It's already affected my walking quite badly. It's playing up my hip really, really severely. And when you think back in 2019, halfway through the year when I had the steroid injections, I thought I was cured. I thought it would all gone away. And you'll see that from my channel as well, because there is part of, I think it's some part of my journey of Hernia Nightmare, and I finally got through it. And there's one of the relief I could start to get back on with my life. But yeah, I mean, I even went on holiday last year, September, so September 2019. Going on holiday with an overactive bladder or a bladder issue with hernia or with a potential hernia. Yeah, it was interesting. It was very upsetting at times, very gutting. I'm a young man. Couldn't do what I wanted to do. Couldn't just go out for trips and things. Always had to think of where the bathroom was. Yeah, you can imagine. Devastating. Even on the flight. Yeah. Of course, I put on a show. I am very good at putting on an act of smiling and that everything is absolutely fine. But we can all do that, can't we? We really, really can all do that. But deep down inside, many of us can be absolutely collapsing. Or crumbling, even. Emotionally, I mean. And it's difficult. It really, really is difficult. And I am now in, as we all are, June 2020, and my bladder problem is horrific. I get worse days, and I do get the odd good day. And of course, with the coronavirus pandemic, I was meant to be going in because with that said, I have had tests about this bladder problem this year. I have had a urodynamics test, which is of course where they put a tube up into your bladder, and yes, it is as uncomfortable and as painful as it sounds, with them filling your bladder up and testing the pressure and all different functions of your bladder. I have then had a flexible cystoscopy, which is a camera and a tube, a very nasty, horrible device, up into your bladder. Yes, as a man, you can well imagine how uncomfortable that is, and believe you me, it is excruciatingly painful, and it's nasty, horrible, humiliating. And yeah, if you're watching this, don't watch this if you're going to be having one of those done, will you? I probably shouldn't be saying that, but do you know what, I'm a fond believer that these problems will get better, and I'm sure there will be brighter days ahead. It's all because I was, and of course, the bonus, I should say, from these tests, I was then put forward that they had noticed that I had a very small bladder capacity as well, which wasn't helping. So after having the urodynamics test and the flexible cystoscopy, which, forgive me for that, that was pretty nasty of me saying that, but they weren't pleasant. I'm not going to lie to you, they were not pleasant at all. I was then, after I'm due to have an operation for a fixed cystoscopy, to take some biopsies from my bladder, to do some more tests, further tests with me under anaesthetic, and then changing the size of my bladder, so increasing the capacity of my bladder, which I was looking forward to, which sounds strange, doesn't it? But with it affected so much of my life, I was looking forward to getting an aspect of my life back, or getting my life back on track, and feeling like I want to feel. Yeah, the coronavirus pandemic really put pay to that, but I can understand, and all routine surgeries were cancelled. On the back of that as well, I've had a few scares with the hernia, and this third one, going back quite a few weeks now, maybe even a month or more, I was stepping out of the bath and the hernia dropped, and it must have caught on something, because the absolute excruciating pain, I literally thought that I was dying. I absolutely thought that, what have I done? Something's happened. And within about an hour, maybe a bit longer than that, it wore off and it went and it passed. But I was left with a lot of discomfort and a lot of pain. So I went to the doctors very urgently after that. And it was suggested I should have gone to A&E. But accident and emergency, but I didn't. So then they made me a priority referral to a recurrent hernia specialist, because of course this is the third one. I've got quite a lot going in that area, and you know, it's causing me so much more of an issue. Only actually last night it came down even further. And when I say that, a hernia in your groin drops, and it drops, so from my scar it drops quite low, of course, well underneath, so you can feel this very warm hot bulge, because I have a lot of problems with the nerves in my leg, which, whether or not that's from the surgery, whether that's from the hernia, I don't know, but I get a lot of discoloration in my leg, like a bluey tinge at times as well, and when that hernia drops through, I get a real hot sensation, like pins and needles all the time, and I've had that for a very, very long time throughout all of these experiences with hernias. But yeah, so I'm sorry my update is not positive. I do feel rubbish at the moment, if I'm being honest. Dealing with a bladder problem so much all the time, waking me up in the middle of the night, causing me all sorts of problems, does affect your mood. I feel as low, probably, as I've ever felt. I've never felt this low, to be quite honest with you. I have a great support network. I have amazing parents. I have my amazing nan, who I love and I cherish, and And even though she has Alzheimer's, I confide in her, I talk to her, and it really, really helps. We're very, very close. But I talk to my mum mostly about things, and my dad. And yeah, without them, I just don't know how I would get through this, to be honest with you. But when all of the coronavirus pandemic, which I absolutely count my blessings, because so many people have had horrific things happen to them, and so many tragic things have happened, and of course people have lost their lives through this, and my heart goes out to them and every single family affected by this. And you know what, if we can move forward from this, goodness knows how we can. And some people may never deal from this, and of course they won't after losing somebody. And please don't think that I'm taking anything away. A bladder problem or a hernia problem does not compare what those people have gone through. But it's just that when you have a problem like what I've got, it really wears you into the ground. And I just cannot wait for things to, for us to get a sense of normality, so I can start to get my appointments back up. Whether it be scans and get, and do you know what, unfortunately I can't even have it all done in one operation, so I have to have this bladder operation, I have to have another hernia repair, two separate operations, two separate recovery periods. Great. But we stay positive, don't we? That's the one thing, we stay positive. And I absolutely am an advocate for that. We must cherish life, because none of us are promised the tomorrow, and I absolutely stand by that. I really, really do. It's just at the moment I felt I wanted to do a recap. I've had a few really, really amazing caring comments actually from people on my channel about this problem, and if you're going through it, stay strong and talk to one another, talk to people, talk to your family. It really, really helps, because carrying this burden around with an overactive bladder is horrific. It really, really is a nasty issue. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy, because it really affects me on an hourly basis. I'm not going to say on a daily basis, on an hourly basis. And even now, it's worse. You'd think through staying at home through the coronavirus pandemic, it would be better, wouldn't you? Staying at home does me no good at all. I need to be out every day, because it makes me anxious if I can manage the bladder problem. Do you know what I mean? It really, really does. And then when I go out anywhere, of course, a lot of public facilities now are closed. So it just is a real horrible, festering, horrible, vicious circle. From the bladder problem to the mental health issues as well, which comes along with that too. Yeah, so I'm sorry my recap isn't positive. Have things changed from the last time we spoke about it? Not at all. Has things got worse? Probably. Hugely, probably. I'm now in a situation where I have another hernia. I'm now in a situation where I have more so of a horrific bladder problem. So yeah, I'm pretty miserable. But do you know what? I'm quite good at putting an act on. I'm quite good at being positive. And at the end of the day, there is somebody by far worse off. And the last week or so, I'm having a really, really bad time to see any positivity about it. But you know what? Tomorrow's another day, and I will stay positive. I think the thing is, at the moment, what's really, really getting me, only a couple of nights ago, I could really feel the hernia dragging more and more and more. So of course, that makes my bladder problem even worse. And it's just nasty and horrific, and really, really affects me in so many ways. But yeah, I mean, for the bladder problem, I have tried so many different medications, all of which If it's a bladder medication, by the way, you can guarantee that it's got side effects. And some of them are pretty, pretty grim, I have to admit. Some of them are pretty nasty. I've had ones which have made me feel like I'm going to keep coming over feeling lightheaded and faint. Yeah, not nice. But what I would say, let's turn this onto a positive note as I draw this to an end, is that if you do find yourself with an overactive bladder, or possibly yourself, and you've got hernia problems as well, and it's affecting your bladder, you will get through this. I've got through it twice, and I've had short breaks in between before I've then had another hernia. So I will get through this, you will get through this, and do you know what? What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. I do believe that. Simple. I do believe that. And with all this, with this coronavirus pandemic, if we listen to what we're being told, brighter days will follow. And I'm standing true to that. I really do feel that. There's so many good things in life. That's what I try and concentrate on. And you know what? I had an amazing comment from an amazing lady on YouTube who said, isn't it incredible that we have the choice to be happy? We don't have the choice to do many things in this life, but we have the choice of happiness and we have the choice to be happy. So that I find really empowering, really incredible. And on that note, thank you very, very much for watching my clip. It means the world to me. This is a huge issue and it's a very, very nasty issue. But I can see the path through it, I think, and we will get there. So on that note, thank you very much for watching and sharing this clip with me. And until next time, we will see you then. Bye bye now.